Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another Blu-ray collection update and unboxing. If you all don't know me, I'm David Cantu, and I review movies over at CinemaDeviant.com. I started doing this as a way to give people a heads up as to what's coming out now and in the upcoming weeks as far as Blu-rays and DVDs go. This week, we have a pretty good amount to check out and some really good titles as well, some really exciting movies. It feels like I haven't done one of these in a while. I think it's been like about almost like a full week since one of these videos has gone up. So if it may not, you know, seem like it's a long time to you, to me it feels like it's been forever. But let's go ahead and get started. First up is Officer Down. And this is out actually now from Magnet Releasing, a subsidiary of Magnolia Home Entertainment. So this movie I heard about, I probably want to say almost a year ago. It looks ridiculous, but in the best possible way. As you can see here, it does say, if you thought Deadpool was sick, you ain't seen nothing yet. And that's by, the Los Angeles Daily News. Now, to compare it to Deadpool is probably a stretch. But, from the look of it, from the trailer that I did see, from the clips that I did see, it looks like it's going to be an insane film. It is based on a graphic novel. So right there, it's going to be very, you know, out there. It looks like it's going to be very violent, almost like the way Machete was, in that kind of sense, that kind of violence and stuff like that. So that's going to be really fun to watch. And fun fact, if you all don't know, it is directed by Sean Crahan from Slipknot. This guy right here. So yeah, very surprising. If you've seen some of his, the music videos that he's directed for Slipknot, you'll kind of get a sense of his directing style. So I'm very excited to check this one out. And Kim Coates is in it. Kim Coates from Sons of Anarchy. He's always fun to watch on screen as well. I'm going to pop this open. Right. I miss making these messes. I'm not going to lie. Again, like I said, it feels like it's been forever. I know it probably hasn't been that long, but it just feels that way. Been so busy with the podcast and stuff lately. And writing reviews, Oscar season, yeah. All right, let's go ahead and pop this open. All right, well, here goes the front, much like the slipcover. The back here, much like the slipcover. And then the inside, doesn't have any interior artwork, but there is disc art, which is very awesome. It is very similar to, you know, to the cover there, but that's okay. At least there's disc art, right? There goes the front, back, and spine. And I forgot to show you guys. If you guys want to know what it's about, you can read it there. All right. And the one thing I did like about the slipcover is that there's actually, it's embossed pretty good. As you can tell right there, it's raised. Got the whole gun. Text up here. Sunglasses. And actually, Kim Coates' face, the outline of his face is raised. That's really cool. They don't do that a lot. They don't, Magnet Releasing and Magnolia Pictures, they don't do a whole lot of slipcovers. Not normally, anyway. Only for their for special films, and this is a special film. I mean, it's going to be a special film. I haven't seen it again. Like I said, I saw a trailer, but I know I'm gonna love it. I know if you're into that kind of stuff too, Robert Rodriguez type, you know, absurdities and violence and stuff like that, you're gonna love this movie. I know you are. This one is out now from Magnet Releasing. Next up is something. I haven't seen this character in a very long time. This used to be one of my favorite characters when I was a kid. I would like to see if it translates and resonates with me now, and if I still think it's funny. And it's Ernest. it's Ernest. the complete series, 13 episodes, starring Jim Varney. I loved it, man. I loved these Ernest movies growing up. I love the character, you know what I mean? And it was just, it was one of those characters. He was just so silly, so out there, so dumb. And I guess it kind of spoke to me in a sense. Let's go ahead and pop this open. But again, like I said, I'd like to check out now, check it out now and see how, you know, how it translates. If it's still funny to me, it might, because I have, sometimes I can have a really stupid sense of humor. So there's a good possibility there. All right. It does have a digital code, which is surprising. All right. And then there you go. No interior artwork. There is disc art, because Mill Creek Entertainment always does disc art for their stuff, which is very, very much appreciated. Even if it's just basic, you know, saying that, and that's funny, the hole is where his mouth is. but it's very much appreciated. I love that they do that. It's Ernest, the complete series, is out now from Mill Creek Entertainment. So look for it. Look for it if you're interested. I highly doubt that it's going to be very pricey, since it's only one disc, 13 episodes. I'm going to go ahead and go on a limb and guess that it's probably going to be about $10. If not, maybe about like $7. No more, I would say no more than $10. So look for it if you're interested. If you remember the character, let me know in the comments below. What was one of your favorite Ernest appearances? Mine was Ernest Scared Stupid. That was one of my favorite movies that I love to watch. All right, next up is an interesting movie. This movie is super interesting. I loved it from the first time that I saw it, and I loved it so much, and it was so intriguing to me that I had to watch it multiple times to fully get the experience from it. And that is Nocturnal Animals. And this is starring Amy Adams and Jake Gyllenhaal. Directed by Tom Ford. Which was really weird to me. Because I had no idea Tom Ford even was a filmmaker. I just thought he made suits. So when I found out that this was directed by Tom Ford originally, I was like, the same guy that does suits and fashion stuff? And so yeah, so it was a little... it caught me by surprise, but in the best possible way, because this movie is shot beautifully. It is, the cinematography on it is just amazing. I loved it from beginning to end. Everything about this movie was intriguing to me. You know, I don't want to give too much away, but there's two stories that kind of serve each other, I guess you could say, in a sense. And the stuff that each of these characters go through is just wow. You know, when I watched the first time, I was kind of taken aback by it, and at the same time, I was like, wow, it was beautiful, but it was so like ugly at the same time. I don't know if you watch it, I think you'll probably, or if you've watched it, you probably understand what I'm trying to say. I'm trying not to say too much about it, but. Wonderful movie. I loved it. And there are things very metaphorical, you know, in certain aspects where you kind of, like I said, that's why I had to watch it multiple times, because there were certain things that I felt like I didn't fully grasp the first time around. And I wanted to make sure that I understood certain things, or I had my take on certain things. Awesome movie. Phenomenal movie. I highly recommend getting this movie. If you're not into, like, you know, again, like, analyzing film or analyzing certain things, analyzing story, you may not like it. I will admit that. But if you are, again, hands down, you will love this movie. All right, very basic, you know, discs here, very reflective and then not so reflective. The usual universal, you know, disc art here. And there goes the front. Back and spine for Nocturnal Animals. This one is out now from Universal Studios Home Entertainment. And it was already open because I had to watch it. I had to hurry up and watch it to review. And it had been a while since I had seen it, so I needed to watch it again. So forgive me for that. All right, next up is Man Down. And this one is out March 7th from Lionsgate. This one does star shot... it's going to get me again. Because I know, I recognize his name, but I never know if I'm saying it right. Shia LaBeouf? Shia LaBeouf? LaBeouf? I don't know. Shia LaBeouf. I will just leave it at that. There you go. Starring Shia LaBeouf, Jai Courtney, Gary Oldman, Kate Mara, and Clifton Collins Jr. Great cast. Great cast right there, right off the bat. And this is an intriguing movie as well. If you can see there what it's about, you can understand why. It sounds interesting to me, at least, to check out. And like I said, with the cast involved, it's definitely something that you know, you guys may want to see. Strong cast, very strong cast. I love all the actors involved. And Shia is a great actor. You know, he has his things outside, his personal life and stuff like that. He's a weird guy. He can be a weird guy. Very strong actor. And I've said that from the start, even when he was on Even Stevens back in the day. All right. It was Even Stevens, right? Now I'm starting to second guess myself. All right. Let's see here. Any stickers? Okay. Does come with digital copy. And bam, Lionsgate hooked it up. Some disc art there. No interior artwork, and that's to be expected. Disc art, it is the same, but there's disc art. So thank you, Lionsgate, for doing that at least. I appreciate that every time. And I say that every time, and I mean it though. Because it, you know, just that little bit of extra, you know, care, that little extra thing that they throw in there goes a long way, especially for me. And this one is out March 7th. From Lionsgate. All right. Next up is a movie that, from what I've heard from other people and that other people have told me, is kind of controversial in a way. And I don't know if it's my kind of movie going into it. I've never seen it before. Some people, I've heard both sides of the fence. You know, one group of people saying, well, you know, It's beautiful in a certain way. You know, the way it's shot, cinematography, it looks awesome. Visionary director, Mexican director. On the other side of the fence, well, it involves incest. That's what I heard, anyway. I'm not a fan of that. So, that's why going into it, I don't know how I'm going to feel about it. I will watch it. I will check it out. I'll give it a shot. I'll give it a chance. Because, you know, I mean, that's what, as movie watchers, as cinephiles, that's what we do. You know, we have to give these films a chance, no matter if they make us feel uncomfortable or what have you. I will admit, and I will say it right now, that if it makes me feel a little too uncomfortable, if it is a little too out there, I'm cutting it off. That's it. I'm stopping the movie. That's it. I'm gonna just plant my foot down right now and say that, okay? So, and this one is it's called We Are the Flesh, and this one is out now from Arrow Video. Now, Arrow Video, I've never known Arrow Video to be this. You know, I guess I don't know. I mean, maybe they have in the past. I've never known them to be this controversial with a, you know, I guess a subject matter like that in a movie. That's kind of more, and I will just say it, artsploitation films realm of stuff to go. They make you feel really uncomfortable at times with certain films that they put out. Certain ones, not all of them. But yeah, so, I mean, if Arrow Video's putting it out, they're putting it out probably for the art. The art of it, the artistic, you know, side of things. So, like I said, I am going to give it a chance. I've never seen it before, and I've always told you guys that I don't like to go by hearsay. You know, if somebody's telling me that movie's bad, okay, well, that's your opinion. I'm going to watch it myself. So, definitely I am going to, you know, check it out myself. Wow, okay. Booklet here. That's like nightmare fuel. Right there. And then if you flip it this way, there's that. All right. Yeah, very Just same stuff, production photos, things like that. Don't want to really show too much, just in case. There. All right. And there goes the disc there, the Blu-ray. I mean, very nice disc art. And it's very different as far as color goes, anyway. Different from the cover there. All right. And as with all Arrow Video releases, there is alternate art there. I kind of don't like that one. That one looks a little, I don't know. Looks a little weird to me. I prefer this commissioned artwork. The commissioned artwork is usually the best there. Let me see here. I'll show you guys the back so you guys, in case you guys want to know what it's about. And let me know your guys' take on this film and what you guys think about it. If you've seen it before, how do you feel about this film? I'm very curious to hear the consensus of people's feelings on this. There you go. There goes the special features. All right. And then the front, back, and spine of We Are the Flesh. And that is out now from Arrow Video. All right. All right. Next up is Allied. Now, this one was the movie that caused a little bit of controversy, mainly in the personal life of Brad Pitt. This movie came out at, or was coming out around the same time that him and Angelina Jolie decided to divorce. And she was being put in the middle of it. What was her name? Marion Cotillard. She was kind of being put in the middle of it. And my memory from this movie, every time I see this movie, all I remember is her saying, "I have nothing to do with it. Y'all do your thing. I'm pregnant. I got my husband." And you know, it just felt like so drama filled, like the press part of this movie. And I don't even think Brad Pitt did any press for this movie, which is very, very odd. You know, I mean, I guess considering, you know, what had just happened, I don't blame him. But there you go. And this one is the 4K disc. Does have the 4K Ultra HD, Blu-ray, and digital copy. And this one is out now from Paramount Home Entertainment. And this one was open as well because I had to watch it. So if you guys don't know what it's about. All right, we'll pause it there. And special features as well. All right. So it does have digital copy. And nothing too crazy. Again, the black cases are always super awesome. Love them. Blu-ray here, because it's blue. It's a blue disc. And the 4K Ultra HD copy of Allied here. Again, even though it's so simple, just black cover art with the logo up on top, I kind of dig it. I kind of dig these 4K copies more than the Blu-ray copies lately, anyway. And here goes the front, back, and spine. And like I said, Allied is out now from Paramount Home Entertainment. So look for it then. I actually dug this movie. It was pretty good. It was a lot better than I thought it was going to be. Which, you know, we'll get more to that. And, you know, if you guys want me to, I'll review this film. The review will be up on the site on cinemadeviant.com. Shameless plug. later on as well. Next up is The Eyes of My Mother. And this one is out March 7th from Magnet Releasing. As I said, a subsidiary of Magnolia Home Entertainment. So when this movie came in the mail, everybody in my house just like was like, "What is that? Ugh, like, get it away." So cover art, Blu-ray cover art, sometimes it does wonders. You know, so I don't know what the movie's about. Apparently, it's a horror movie because it says, hands down, one of the best horror movies of the year. But I'm excited to check it out. Magnet, and I've said it many times, and I'll say it again. Magnet Releasing always puts out great, great horror films, great genre films, but really fantastic, visionary horror films at times. So I'm really excited to check this out. And if you guys want to see what it's about right there. All right, special features. The wording is a little small there. You can read it. All right. So, I mean, it looks interesting as hell. I'm ready. I'm ready to check this out. I've been ready to watch a really good horror movie. I've yet to see Get Out, but that's on my radar. That's going to be sometime this week. I'm going to go watch that. I mean, it's just that Get Out is one of those movies that, again, is very surprising. It's directed by Jordan Peele. So I think that has me more intrigued than anything. All right, let's go ahead and pop this open. All right. No digital copy, no interior artwork, but there is disc art. And pretty much the cover here. But that's okay. At least there's disc art. All right. And then there goes the front, back, and spine. And The Eyes of My Mother does come out March 7th from Magnet Releasing. So if this intrigues you at all, definitely, definitely pick this up. Again, you know, they put out some really good movies at times. And I'm excited to check this one out. Really excited. But when am I not excited? Like, seriously, legitimately, yeah, I'm excited to see pretty much every movie. Except for We Are the Flesh. I don't know. Anyway, next up, last but not least, is Moonlight. The big winner at the Oscars. You know, amidst their big flub at the end, they came out on top and won Best Picture. And this one is out now from Lionsgate. I will say that it was very deserving. This movie is phenomenal. It's not your typical film that you're gonna watch. It honestly took me by surprise. You know, in a sense, because even like, okay, and I'll turn this around right now so you can read what it's about. I read what it's about on the back. I had no idea what it was about. You know, even in reading it, it gives you the basis of what it's about. But what you see on screen is something else. And, you know, and it's something else, but not in a bad way. It was very interesting, very intriguing to me. And this movie took you down paths that, it could make some people feel a little uncomfortable. But that's what great movies do. They make you feel uncomfortable at times. You know, and, you know, going back to that other film that I said I wasn't, you know, too comfortable with, that's why I'm going to check it out either way. You know, so anyway, this movie did phenomenally. It's a fantastic movie. There you go. Want to read what it's about? I see the special features as well. Now, I will say one thing about this movie is that The one thing that I didn't like was that I felt like there was a lot more story to tell. I felt like it shouldn't have ended. I don't want to say it shouldn't have ended the way it did, but maybe what I mean is it shouldn't have ended. Not like that in any way. But I feel like there was a good chunk of story that still could have been told. It still needed to be told. And, you know, it struck me on a certain level. You know, this kid, you know, goes through a lot of experiences. The one thing that I could identify with, I couldn't identify with everything. And you'll understand why. But the one thing that I could identify with was growing up in the rough part of town. You know, growing up in a rough neighborhood and just getting by and being, you know, hassled all the time. You know, that was the one thing that really struck with me. And I couldn't, you know, that was the one thing I couldn't shake about the movie. And it's always funny because I do a lot of stuff. I'm always busy forever. And when I can sit down and watch a movie and not... Or the movie will take my attention so much that I completely just shut down everything else that I'm doing and I'm in the film. That to me shows, you know, how great a movie it is. How great the directing was, how great the acting was, It was a great movie all around. I loved it. I cannot recommend this one enough. So definitely watch it. Does come with digital copy. And I'm sorry if I talk too much about that one. I was trying to explain a little bit of you know, why you guys should watch this movie. It did win Best Picture, so there goes another reason as well. It must be good, right? All right. No, interior artwork does have the typical grayish Lionsgate, you know, disc art there, which sucks. But, you know, it's something at least. It does have the logo there. It says Moonlight. All right. And there goes the front, back, and spine. And Moonlight is out now from Lionsgate. So, definitely, if you're into, you know, the Academy Awards and those type of movies, the Oscar winners and stuff like that, this is definitely one to watch. I wonder if they're going to release a variant slipcover that says, you know, Oscar winner, Academy Award winner, Best Picture, da da da. Because if they would have waited to release this, you know, maybe a month or so, maybe they could have stopped that, or they could have, you know, fixed that instead of the Golden Globe thing. But anyway, thank you guys for watching. That's all we have for this week. If you dug any of these titles at all, please give this video a thumbs up. Or if you're excited about any of them at all, if you're going to pick up any of them, give this video a thumbs up. There will be links down in the description below if you guys want to purchase them through my links. It does help me out a lot. You don't have to, but it's much appreciated if you do. And please, 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 please hit that subscribe button if you guys have not already. We're at about like 1,500 or so, almost 1,600 subs. Trying to get to 2,000 pretty soon. When I get to 2,000... I'm trying to see if I could put together a good giveaway for you guys. So anyway, let's try to push to 2,000 if we can. And with all that being said, thank you very much, and we will catch you next time. Bye.